So this is very much like a nocturne, like a night piece. It has the same kind of proportions. Nocturnes in Chopin's style typically have outer sections that are very quiet, and the middle section will have the climax. So this is followed then by the Prelude in B flat minor, number 16. And this one doesn't really follow a classical form. It's just a continuous open-ended. So let's put here open form. It has continuous 16th notes in the right-hand scales and broken chord patterns, and the left hand has this accompaniment pattern that has rests on the second and fourth beats. And basically have that same pattern throughout the Prelude. A lot of times these Preludes will just have that one idea. They won't be an ABA like the Raindrop. They'll just have, you know, basically one mood. And so this one is very dramatic and is one of the high points of the whole set. So they're very much opposites. All right, so the Raindrop Prelude puts you into a state of reverie. The B-flat minor will jar you to wake you up out of it. last work of Chopin that we're going to listen to is one of his nocturnes. So he wrote 19 nocturnes. And this is the one in C sharp minor. It was published same time, 1838. So opus 27, number 1. The nocturne is a type of work that emerged in the early Romantic period, and it was associated with the Irish pianist John Peel. So he was the first to write nocturnes. So it's a type of night piece. So it has this dreamy, kind of reflective atmosphere. So Chopin really brought the genre into a more sophisticated and greater conception. And typically there would be three sections. The outer sections would be more quiet and have that nocturne quality. The middle section would have a big build-up. And so that's the situation here. So overall, it's a ternary, compound ternary form. Those preludes cross. So again, this begins with an accompaniment pattern that spans a 12th pedal depressed. So two measures of just this open fifth sound. You don't know what key it's in yet, and so the first note of the melody, and then it sounds an E natural, which places it in C sharp minor, then immediately goes up chromatically to E sharp, which functions as a 5/4, dissolves up another half step, so you have this chromatic opening with the melody. One of the harmonies that this nocturne works with a lot is the Neapolitan harmony in measure 5. And so you have that D major that's over a C sharp pedal tone. So you have that D major with a C sharp beneath it. It gives a sense of dissonance about it. It's really beautiful. The end of the first phrase cadences on E major at measure 7. And then it restates the opening of the melody again, and with that Neapolitan harmony in measures 9 and 10. At measure 11, then you have a new little idea that's presented. Again, you keep sounding that D natural. So measure 13, that's sent against a 5/7 harmony. And again, it gives it that kind of dissonant quality, but it's something that's very poignant. You have that Neapolitan again in measure 17, the third beat. At the bottom of the page, then it restates the opening. Now you add a second voice in the right hand. And this whole section ends with just this Neapolitan harmony that's just cast over a C sharp pedal tone beginning at measure 25. So that whole line has that harmony. So that's the most characteristic sound of the opening section. The middle section begins at 29 then. He writes più mosso, more motion, so this is a little faster. There's going to be a couple of big arrival points in this. So these opening phrases are all rising in pitch level. Turn over to the next page, and it at measure 45 is fortissimo, and it ends up with a triple forte at measure 49 on A flat major. And this first buildup arrives in that key of A flat major. Then you have another buildup that begins at 53. And again, this is going to be rising in pitch, and it has an arrival point at measure 65. At measure 65, then you have this new melody that is like a mazurka. So this is a typical kind of Chopin dance mazurka figure. And that's first presented in D flat major. And then it just real quickly modulates in measure 72 down a half step to C major. And you have the same thing that's now pianissimo in C major. You have a lot of chromaticism in this passage. It leads to a 5-7 back in the key of C sharp minor on the bottom system, measure 83. You have a left hand recitative passage. And so this is one of those passages that's in smaller note heads that doesn't have bar lines. It has rhythmic values, but it's not placed within a meter. And that then is the final connecting passage back to an abbreviated return of the opening page. And so that last page is the return of the A section, and it then measure 94, it has a little codetta. And at 94, then it switches to C sharp major. And at 96, you have some blurring together of harmonies. This sounds like a lot like Debussy. So Claude Debussy is very much influenced by Chopin. And so at this kind of out of focus effect. And it ends in C sharp major, so it has that kind of overall kind of a Picardy third idea. It's very, very beautiful.